rock and roll, what she gonna do? Rock and roll, what she gonna do? She'll travel around from friend to friend, her fun adventures never end. Rock and roll, what she gonna do?
Don't forget about me, Ruth, too. Hang in my toes until we get to your show.
Rock and roll, and roll too. What are they gonna do?
Well, hi there, friends. How are we today? I'm so happy to see you. I was just playing this instrument right here. It's called an Irish whistle or an Irish flute, because today we're going to join Rock and Roo and celebrate the music from Ireland. Grab an instrument or a scarf. Let's have some fun and do our hello song together, friends. Hi, friends. Hi, Rock and Roo. I am so excited to be all together today. Let's sing and have some fun.
Hello, my friends, and how do you do? I'm so glad.
I'm gonna go first and show us what to do. I'm gonna do some disco dancing, my friends.
Hello, Miss Katie, how do you do? I'm so glad I'm here with you. Who is next? Please tell us your name. Do something silly and we'll do the same.
Thank you so much for singing to me, my friends. Okay, it is Rockin' Roo's turn. Let's sing to Rockin' Roo. Okay, my friends, it is your turn.
Hello, and how do you do? I'm so glad I'm here with you. And now that we know everyone, let's sit down and have some fun.
Let's have some fun, everybody. So we're going to start our celebration of Ireland off today with a song just for our littlest little ones. And this is called 1, 2, 3, Me Mother Caught a Flea. And this is a great lap bounce for those little babies and toddlers. So we're going to put them up on our laps like this, and we're going to bounce them as we say these words. So 3 bounces, 2, 1, 2, 3. And then again, me mother caught a flea. And then we're going to bounce them in a circle. She put it in the teapot and made a cup of tea. And then we're going to lift them up in the air in this next part. The flea jumped out. Ooh, they're going to love that part. Me mother gave a shout over to the side and then keep bouncing. And in came daddy with the shirt hanging out and over to the other side. So we're going to do this a couple times in a row just to get the feel of it. You know what, big kids, I bet if you ask really nicely, you might be able to sit on mom and dad's lap for this one too. It's a really, really silly one. Let's get the bounce going. And here we go. 1, 2, 3. Me mother caught a flea circle. She put it in the teapot and made a cup of tea. Here's our jump. The flea jumped out. Me mother gave a shout, and in came the daddy with the shirt hanging out. Oh no! Let's try it one more time, and here we go. 1, 2, 3. Me mother caught a flea circle. She put it in the teapot and made a cup of tea. The flea jumped out. Me mother gave a shout, and in came the daddy with the shirt hanging out. Oh, good job, friends. I love bounces with my little ones. All right, friends, I want to show you one of my favorite songs from Ireland called The Rattlin' Bog. Now, a bog is a marshland or wetlands, and we're going to tell the story about what's in this bog. For instance, there's a hole in the ball. Can you make a big hole like this? Good. And in the hole there is a tree. Can you make a tree? And on the tree there is a limb. Stretch your arm out to be a limb. Good. On the limb there is a nest. Can you make a nest? And in the nest there is an egg. Perfect. And in the egg there is a bird. And on the bird there is an itty bitty little flea. And every time we introduce something new, you're going to hear me say the word rattling. Now think about the word rattle. What instrument would work well for the word rattle? Like a shaking sound. Egg shakers would work, or maracas. Very good. So when you hear me say that word rattling, I want you to shake your body all around and rattle your shaky eggs or your maracas. All right, friends. This song is a lot of fun, and it's going to test your memory. So let's sing the rattling bog together.
Oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, now in that bog there was a hole, a rare hole, a rattling hole. And the hole in the bog, in the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. That hole there was a tree, a rare tree, a rattling tree. And the
tree in the hole, in the hole, in the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, now on that tree there was a limb. A rare limb, a rattling limb. And the
limb on the tree, in the tree, in the hole, in the hole, in the bog, down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, now on that limb there was a nest, a rare nest. A rattling nest. And the
nest on the limb, in the limb, on the tree, in the tree, in the hole, in the hole, in the bog, down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh,
now in that nest there was an egg, a rare egg, a
on the limb, in the limb, on the tree, in the tree, in the hole, in the hole, in the bog, down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh,
now in that egg there was
a bird,
a rare bird, a rattling bird. And the
bird in the egg, in the egg, in the nest, on the limb, in the limb, on the tree, in the tree, in the hole, in the hole, in the bog, down in the valley. Oh,
oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh,
one more.
And on that bird there was a flea, a rare flea, a rattling flea.
On the bird, in the bird, in the egg, in the egg, in the nest, on the limb, in the limb, on the tree, in the tree, in the hole, in the hole, in the bog, down in the valley. Oh,
oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. Oh,
I think I'm just going to sit back and be nice and calm and relax. I love
hey, piano.
Forte.
How's it going?
Forte, what are you doing? I'm trying to relax, and you're running back and forth. That's not
helping.
Forte.
I've got to exercise. Got to keep the blood pumping. gotta stay fit. Wanna join me?
I think I just prefer to sit here and rest calmly. Thank you. 14, can you slow down, please? Slow down. Slow. There you go. Slow. Ooh, yeah, all right. Yeah, take it easy. There you go. All right.
Oh, phew. My heart is really beating fast, Piano. I wonder why that is.
Well, Forte, it's because you were running very fast. The faster your body runs, the faster your heartbeat is. See, now, if you were to check my pulse, yeah, see, it's nice and slow because I was trying to relax and go slow, yeah.
Oh, I got it. Faster movement makes a faster heartbeat.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. You know what, Forte?
What?
Music works the same way.
What?
Yeah.
Music exercises? Note to self, get guitar running shoes for his birthday.
Oh, no, Forte. Yeah. Forte, music doesn't actually exercise, but all songs have a beat, just like our heartbeat.
Oh.
Now, when the song is faster, like a dance song, the beat of the song is faster. But when the song is slow, like a lullaby, the beat of the song is slower. Now, in music, we call that tempo.
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 Yeah, tempo.
Tempo.
Tempo. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's
tempo.
A fun word.
Isn't it?
Check this out, Piano.
What?
Fast tempo. Slow tempo. Fast tempo. Slow tempo. Fast slow. Fast slow.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Uh-huh. I think you got it, Forte. I think
yeah,
you got it.
I got
hey,
it.
You know what, Forte? I think I am ready for some exercise now. Yeah. Fast tempo, here I come.
You ready? Great, let's do it.
Okay, ready?
Tempo.
Well, friends, what is your favorite tempo? Do you like to go fast, 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 fast? Or do you like to move a little more slowly? Raise your hand if you like to go fast.
Let me see.
Ooh, me too. I like to go fast, 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 too. In music, the word for a fast tempo is allegro. Can you say that? Allegro. Good. And then as we get a little closer to bedtime and we're slowing things down a bit, we call that tempo largo. That's nice and slow. Can you say largo? Good job! Largo is slow. Well, we're going to have some fun with tempo right now. How many of you know the song? Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. You've heard that song before, right? But did you know there's an Irish version of this song too? Let me show you what the words are in English for this. We're going to put up one hand. Hand, other hand, then count to two. One, two, then do it with feet. Foot, other foot, one, two. Head, nose, mouth, and chin. And then I need to see your big old smile. With white teeth inside my mouth. And then we're going to give a big old smile, show off those pearly whites. Very good. Now, we're going to do this song a little bit faster each time we sing it. The first way is going to be the version we know really well. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Then we'll go to our Irish version. Hand, other hand, one, two. And then the two fastest ways, we're going to do the Irish version again, but we're going to do it in Gaelic. Now, Gaelic is an old language from Ireland. You'll recognize the motions, but the words are going to sound a little bit different to your ear. Let's put this all together with the music. It's called Lav La Vela. When it starts, we're going to put our hands on whatever body part we're singing about. We're going to start with those heads, shoulders, and toes. Here we go.
Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes, and eyes.
Well done, friends. Okay, we're going to do the Irish version in English. Hand, other hand. Get ready. Here we go.
Hand, other hand. One, two. Foot, other foot. One, two. With white teeth inside my mouth.
fast tempo yet. In Gaelic one more time. We've got this, friends. Here we go.
La, la vela ahan a do. Cas, casella ahan a do. Kiaun strong balance me. A gush de klapane immobilische.
Beautiful smiles and well done, friends, as always.
There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. Shaved them off and they grew in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He went fishing with a pin again. Sat all day then reeled it in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Climbed a tree then barked his shin again. Slid back down and scraped his skin again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Ate his dinner from a tin again. What's so good he ate some more again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew fat and then grew thin again. Then he slept and had to begin again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Heard this song and began to sing again. Hurt my ear, so don't begin again. That's the end of Michael Finnegan. Stop!
Oh, hey, Rockin' Roo. What are you up to?
Hey there, Miss Katie. Hi, friends. I'm doing some Irish dancing, and boy, oh boy, is it ever fun.
It looks fun.
And hoppy, which you know I like being a hippity-hoppity kangaroo and all.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it sounds so fun. But Rockin' Roo, why aren't you moving your arms? They're just down there by your side. I don't get it.
Well, Miss Katie, in Irish dancing, most of the work is done with your feet.
Oh.
Your arms stay down most of the time.
Oh, that's interesting, but I wonder why that is.
You know, I actually asked around about that when I got to Ireland, Miss Katie. And you know what cool story someone told me?
What, Rockin' Roo? Tell us.
Well, a long time ago, the country of England was actually the boss of Ireland.
That's
they
right.
were in charge. And they said no dancing,
what?
No singing, no art of any kind that has to do with Ireland.
Oh, no, really?
You betcha. But the Irish figured out a way to break that rule.
Oh, good
the
for them.
The story goes, they started dancing with their arms by their side, so if a British soldier walked by an Irish house and looked in their window, it would look just like the folks inside were walking around or exercising or something, when really, they were dancing with their feet.
Oh, wow, what a fun story. I sure would love to see a real Irish dancer. I wonder how fast they can actually move their feet. What do you think?
Well, I got great news for you, Miss Katie.
What?
I'm here now with my friend Donna, who is an Irish dancer and teacher right here in Ireland.
Oh, yes.
She's going to tell us all about Irish dancing. Yay. And show us some of her super duper Irish dance moves right now.
Yay.
Hey there, Donna.
Hi, Donna.
Hi, kids. Hi, Rockin' Roo.
Hi,
thank you so much for having me.
Oh,
I hope you're all having a great day.
Yep.
So, my name is Donna, and I am from all the way across the world in Ireland.
Ooh.
So, today I'm going to be talking to you about Irish dancing.
Nice.
So, Irish dancing is a sport that allows boys and girls across the world to take part in. So, even though it's Irish dancing, it is in every country in the world.
Ooh, everywhere.
So, today I'm going to show you some of the shoes that we use with Irish dancing. So, firstly, the light shoes. So, the light shoes are nice and soft.
Ooh.
Okay?
Ooh.
So, and they lace up. They're very, very similar to ballet shoes.
Ooh, ballet
but
shoes.
They hurt your feet
yeah.
a lot.
Ooh, ouch,
and
yeah.
they are nice
Ooh.
And bendy. So, it allows us to go right up on our tippy toes.
Ooh,
then,
ooh,
we have the heavy shoes. So, these are obviously called heavy shoes because they are a lot heavier than the little ballet shoes. So, these shoes are the ones that we make the noise with. Can you hear this?
Yeah, hear that? You hear it, kids?
These shoes are the ones that make noise, but they also allow us to go on the tip of our toes. So you can see
ooh,
here,
ooh.
There is a little square that allows us to balance
yeah,
on the top
it.
Of our toes.
Ooh,
so I'm actually going to show you a little demonstration of me doing some light shoe dances and some heavy shoe dances.
All right, can't wait to see it. Let's go. Oh my goodness, she is good. Oh, come on, kids, let's dance along with Donna. must be the heavy shoes because I hear the sound, right, kids? Oh, my goodness me. Fancy footwork indeed.
So now I'm going to talk to you about Irish musical instruments.
Oh.
So these are the instruments that help make the music that we dance to.
That's right, we need
so the
those.
One I'm going to focus on today is called the concertina.
Oh.
So you can see here that the concertina actually looks quite small, but don't underestimate it. It does have the ability to stretch all the way out and all the way in. You'll also see that there are buttons on either side. So when you press the buttons, you pull it out.
Ooh, wow.
And when you press in, a different sound. So a different key.
Two different sounds.
Same on the other side. So one key to pull out and the other key to push in.
All right.
So
out
and in. I hope you enjoyed my video on Irish dancing and the concertina. And thank you so much, kids, and Rocking Roo for listening to my video. Bye.
And thank you to you too, Donna. Bye now.
Bye, Donna.
So,
thank you.
What did you think of Irish dancing, Miss Katie?
Whew, I can't get over how fast her feet were moving. Did you see her go all the way up on her tippity-tippity toes?
Oh, well, sure did. I've been practicing that move ever since I got here. Here, check this out, Miss Katie. Check this out.
Okay, let's see. Oh, careful, Rockin' Roo, careful.
Oh, no. Oops.
Are you okay?
Well, I'll still need some practice, I'll think.
Oh. You know, Rockin' Roo, I think you're right. Let's practice some dancing right now. Would you like to join us, friends? What do you think?
Great!
Yay,
right, I'm ready to go. Let's do it, friends.
I'm ready to go, too. Let's dance. All right, friends. The Irish dance that Rockin' Roo and I are going to show you right now is called the Siege of Carrick. And for the first part of this dance, all we're going to do is go in a circle with your partner. So you can do that by just holding hands and skipping around and around for our little babies and tots. Parents, if you want to hold them and pat the beat on their backs as you turn around, that works great. Rockin' Roo and I are going to show you how to turn doing a star. You're going to form a star with your partner. And you do that by just holding your arm out like that. And you're going to put your hands down on top of each other. So we're going to do a low star, and then we're going to do a high star like that. So let's start by doing a low star. So can you put your hands out like this? And we're just going to turn around in a circle. Turn around, turn around, turn around, then switch. Go the other way. Switch to the other hand. Turn around, turn around, turn around, turn around. Excellent. All right, now let's do a high star. So put your hands up high and turn around again. High star, high star, high star, high star, high star. Switch hands. Other way, other way, other way, other way. Until you're back and facing each other again. You already know half the dance. Good job. All right. Part two. You're going to do a step called a do-si-do. Isn't that a fun word to say? Do-si-do. And to do a do-si-do, you're sort of just going to step and step and step and step. And you're going to go around your partner. You're going to kind of make a circle around your partner. Let's show them how it goes. Ready? Here we go. Do-bum-bum. Do-si-do. 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 And you're back in your spot. That's it. Can you clap two times for me? Ready, Rockin' Roo? Here we go. One, two, and then we're going to link elbows and turn in a circle. Turn around in a circle and you're done. That's the entire dance. So we're going to repeat that all three times in a row. And like I always say, you don't have to do the moves just like us. You can make up your own moves. I just want to see you hopping around and having some fun. So let's dance the Siege of Carrick. Ready, friends? Here we go. Here's that low star. Switch other hand. High star. Switch other hand up high, nice and high. Here's that do-si-do. Two claps. Elbow turn. We're going to do that all again. Do-si-do. And back to that star. Low star. Switch other way, low star. High star. Switch other way. Here's your do-si-do. Two claps. Elbow. Do-si-do again. bounce. Elbow turn and bow to your partner. Yay, friends! You are Irish dancers. So friends, I want to tell you now about another instrument from Ireland because you know Miss Katie loves her drums, right? There's an Irish drum called the boran. Now, what's so neat about this drum is it doesn't have just a single mallet like we're used to playing. It actually has a mallet with two tips on the end of it. It's called a tipper. And you hold it in the middle and go back and forth on the drum to make the sound. Now, I'm going to be showing you in just a little bit how to make your very own boran at home. But for now, to get us in a drumming mood, we're going to do a song called The Drums of Ireland. And we're going to use our drums to tell some Irish rhythms like this. See if you can copy after me. Can you say this? Four leaf clover. Go. Excellent. What about this one? I just saw a leprechaun. Very good. How about this one? Where is his pot of gold? Oh, I know where it is. It's over the rainbow. You are ready to go, friends. The rest of this song, the words will tell you just what to do. Let's have fun and do the drums of Ireland.
Take the Irish way, let's celebrate Ireland.
scarf. I'm going to put it over my head. And in my quietest piano voice, I'm going to sing my peekaboo song. Shh. Where are you hiding? Where could you be? Do you want to play a game of peekaboo with me? Pull off your scarf when you count to three. One, two, again. Should we do it more? One more time? Okay. Scarf goes back on our heads. Back to piano. Shh. Where are you hiding? Where could you be? Do you want to play a game of peekaboo with me? Pull up your scarf when you count to three. One, two, three. I see you out there. All right, friends, hold on to your scarf. We're going to wave it back and forth as we sing our goodbye song together. Here we go.
Goodbye, my friends. Goodbye. We had so much fun.
Here we go. See you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile. Adios, farewell, adieu. I had so much fun with you. I want to say thank you to you, my friends. Thank you to Donna. Thank you to Rock and Rue. I love you so, so, so much. I will see you next time. Bye-bye, friends.
Join us next week as we go on a tour of Africa.